There we go. Oh, hey there. Didn't see you lurking in my basement. Just came back from a camping trip and just putting everything away in the basement. Don't judge. It's messy. Anyway. And I figured just talking about our family tent that we've been using for the last 9 years or so. And took a little bit of video to show you what the tent looks like outside and inside. And the reason why I want to talk about the tent is that, well, it's after 9 years, it has kind of reached the end of its life. Water resistant life, that is. Still a very serviceable tent in fine conditions, but out here on the East Coast, a little bit of wind and rain doesn't make camping that easy. So hopefully we'll get a new tent here. So I just want to give a kind of a long-term review on the Chinook Twin Peaks Guide 6 tent. And let's flip over and take a look at it. Okay, so I shot some video on our last camping trip, and let's run down on the stats really quickly. So this is a 6-person, 3-season tent, but realistically, 4 people will probably be fine in this tent. This weighs 28 pounds and 8 ounces with the fiberglass tent poles, 26 pounds and 4 ounces for the aluminum poles. There's 5 poles in total. There's 2 doors, one in the front and one in the back. First requirement out of the 3 that we wanted in looking for a tent was we wanted an integrated tent and screen tent area. Now, before we used to have a tent and then we would have our separate screen tent around the picnic table, let's say, and that was nice, but out here we normally get a little bit more rain than what is forecast, and therefore if somebody decides to go into the tent, you know, if it's like late at night and stuff, the other person stays in the screen tent, it's not as fun, you're kind of isolated, and plus if it rains pretty hard, the rain will go through the no-see-um mesh anyway. So this has a pretty nice screen tent. It is 5'3" by 9x4, maybe 8x4. The great part of the screen tent also that it came with an additional floor, and it was a nice tarp. It had clip-on, so you could have the choice whether or not you wanted to clip the floor of the screen tent on and off. The second requirement that we had with the tent, you know what, when we're younger, crawling out of the tent on your hands and knees in the mud when it's raining, it's all cute, it's romantic and all that stuff. You know, makes for a nice Instagram post. But as you get older, it sucks. So we wanted high ceilings. That was our second requirement. So this tent here is 6'9" peak. I'm 5'10". Basically, it was enough head clearance for pretty much any area of the tent, even in the screen tent portion of it when you were kind of in the corner. So, which was really good. You know, you get up in the morning, you could stand up straight, you could change, you can walk around. It was fantastic. Combine that with the screen tent where, let's say that it's raining really hard and you can walk into the screen tent, you can change, you're standing up, not a problem, get yourself all dried off, and then you can move into the tent area. Still, you don't have to crawl over somebody or walking over the air mattress, you can just walk in. And the floor space was really nice, you know, the 8x9 floor space for the tent area. So that was pretty nice to walk through, and high ceilings, highly, highly recommend. And the third requirement that we had when we were looking out for this tent back in the day was we needed some rain protection. Out here on the East Coast, wind, rain, we wanted to be dry. So we definitely were looking at tents that had a secondary fly, a full rain fly. Not some of the tents you see now that only covers just a little bit of the tent and leaves everything exposed. Yeah, it's great for air circulation, but when it downpours, everything gets wet. So we wanted a full fly, and there's a nice separation between the poles of the tent and the actual fly, so that when water was dripping down, it would be a good foot or so away from the tent. Combine that with a nice footprint, or what we did, we just went to get a normal blue tarp from the hardware store for a couple bucks, and that would cover, and we would be nice and dry. So that being said, has it been a perfect tent? No, not really. There's a few little things. I don't know if because of the price or the manufacturing or the one that I got, but there was one thing that always bugged me. It was with the door that separated the screen tent and the actual tent portion. And I don't know if it was a manufacturing issue, but it wasn't aligned right. We always needed two hands to close the zipper of the camping door. And you'll see here in the video that there was extra fabric at the top. It was never taut. And you can see there was a little bit of a lip around at the top portion of the door. Now, didn't seem to be a problem, but as years goes on, and recently the tape seams started to peel away. So when it rained, we would get a little bit of moisture, a little bit of rain coming through the seams of the rain fly, and would start to drip down. But with that extra fabric, it would pool the water into the top of the tent, and then it would suddenly drip down inside the tent. And then what used to be a very bone dry, very reliable waterproof tent or the sleeping area, all of a sudden now you see in the corners, you see quite a bit of water. And that was something that really bugged me a lot. And of course the other thing, and you know what, after 9 years, the tent is bound to fail. So we noticed one little rip around the screen tent to tent area, but really the biggest wear that we've seen was with the stitching around the floor of the sleeping tent area. You can see that the stitches are starting to go. There's quite a bit of gap between it. I mean, yeah, you can use duct tape to fix it, but that's just one more thing that kind of like tells you, you know what, maybe it's time to retire this tent. Had a lot of good years of service. Let's just try to find something new. That's about it. Click on the link in the description if you are kind of interested in this tent. I gotta say, I gotta recommend this tent if you're kind of budget conscious and you want to fit, you know, three, maybe four. And if you're a young family, bring this out to camping, just want one structure, this is something you want to look at. I really enjoyed this tent. We as a family enjoyed this tent a lot. Kind of sad that we're gonna retire it. Now you're gonna say, now how come you're not gonna buy another one, Jim? Well, we did 9 years of it. Obviously, there's probably something new that came out. There's a few things that we wanted more of that the other tent didn't quite provide. So we're gonna go up in our budget for the next tent.